I grew up in the late 80s, 90s, so gaming was pretty much everything at that time for us. And so throughout my residency and training, I was always looking for ways that I can combine the two. I'm a pediatric cardiologist at Cincinnati Children's, and I also am the director of digital health innovation. We essentially have a gaming and art studio, kind of a Pixar studio within the hospital. They work together to create not only hands-on experiences, but also content that we use for our patients and our families to be able to better understand their condition. One of the first things I did was develop an application that allowed us to take a patient's anatomy and be able to visualize it in a 3D form using a Unity-based platform. One of the things that we realize is if the surgeon can see the patient's anatomy in advance and be able to plan their surgery off of the anatomy, then that has resulted in our patients having better outcomes. What we wanted to do with Unity was to leverage that game engine component so that we can actually now interact with the data in real time and be able to not only look at it and visualize it from the surgeon's perspective, but be able to plan out each individual step of the operation. And that's what our platform is able to do. The type of data that is being brought into the Unity platform is cross-sectional imaging. So that would be a CT or an MRI. And we take that, we create a 3D render file off of that, and then we bring that into the platform. And then from there, the surgeon can actually plan directly onto the patient's anatomy. They're able to see the heart in different positions than they're able to when they're in the operating room. In the operating room, they only have one particular view. Now they have all types of views all around. Yeah, I would say the real-time aspect of the game engine is probably the most important piece for us because often we will get a request from a surgeon the day before that they have a surgery. Or we have a patient who comes in that's critically ill and they need an emergent kind of operation. For our surgical planning application, the VR3S, what we are looking at doing is collaborating with over 70 children's hospitals in the US and then as many as we can get in contact with worldwide to be able to bring that application directly to them so they can start planning out not only their patient surgeries, but also we've built this almost like a collaborative gaming network, and so that we can have other surgeons working around the world together to be able to provide their expert opinion for the patient in front of them. And then being able to work together to plan out a child's operation, to very much personalize it, but have that global perspective of what would you do in this scenario compared to what have you done in the past. We're using this for really intentional purposes of planning a child's surgery, but we also want to make it so that it's easy to use, it's kind of fun to use, we can engage the surgeons better with it. You want to be able to have really good user experience, user interfaces. I mean, those are things that we have learned from working with Unity to make it a really good game, essentially. Now we've got, you know, the young kids in there who are inevitably better gamers than all of us. They're paired with a surgeon and they're able to plan out their operation together. At the end of the day, we're doctors and we take care of patients. We don't build online gaming networks, but we want to utilize those tools, and so that's where really working with Unity directly has been a great benefit to us. I would love our application just to be available worldwide in any hospital, in any tech setting. So some other future projects we're excited about that would use Unity is create content and games that would allow our patients to be able to interact with it in a language that they understand, which is clearly gaming. So we've created a character named Hank. It starts for heart activity, nutrition, and kindness. And he's a little heart-looking character that is able to interact with different equipment in the hospital, different scenarios that they might have to undergo. And they can use this character to better understand what's going on. If they have to go through imaging, any sort of procedure, using this through character storytelling, through gaming, these are the tools that Unity are providing us. We're going to save way more lives once we have those tools in the hands of the parents and the family members who are the primary caregivers and the first responders. And we can only do that with tools like Unity.